Good evening and welcome to Celebrate Youth. We are so glad that each one of you is here tonight. You are in for such a treat. I've been listening to them rehearse this afternoon, and I just know that you're going to love it. I'm going to ask our senior pastor, Reverend Britt Scarta. There he is. Britt, will you come up and bless this undertaking?
Thank you, Reverend Lindsay, and thank all of you for being here. This is certainly exciting. This is a convergence of a lot of passions we have here at Pulaski Heights, our wonderful foundation that is building a legacy for tomorrow, but also providing for so many of our ministries today. All of us are lovers of our youth ministry, the powerful things that flow out of it. And so I hope you'll be generous tonight. If you weren't at the meal earlier and you could drop a check or leave something for our youth endowment, this is a wonderful project. And so I'm looking forward to hearing the music. I've already studied the program, and some of my favorite pieces are on here. So I'm looking forward to it from beginning to end. Will you bow with me in prayer? Holy God, we thank you for the gift of the church, and we give you thanks for music and arts that inspires us, causes us to soar to new heights. We thank you for the youth of this church and for our foundation that empowers so many ministries here. Bless us as we gather. Bless the food that we shared earlier. Bless all that we engage in here tonight. And may all of this be done for your glory. And we ask all these things in the name and for the sake of your Son, Jesus the Christ, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Britt. We do want to thank everyone who's had a part at all in this endeavor tonight. Joe Knight and her kitchen crew who helped serve the meal. Jennifer Shannon, who not only shopped but cooked and organized and kept us all doing just exactly what we were supposed to do. And Jennifer, we couldn't do these kind of events without you. The Foundation Board, would the Foundation Board members who are here tonight please stand? I'd like for you all to at least get to see faces of your Foundation Board. And we thank you all very much. I want to say thank you to the board for choosing to support Celebrate Youth 2 years ago and then again tonight, because youth ministry is so important to all of us. And we have the most terrific youth ministry here at Pulaski Heights United Methodist Church. We want to say a special thank you to Karen Clark and Jay Clark, and to Grace Jackson, and then to a host of other wonderful youth who are going to be participating tonight. We are delighted that Grace could be on this program because she has sung so beautifully for us throughout the years, and she'll be going away to college next year, and we wish her the very best. We have, you know, when we had baptisms at the church, we all promised to support these children, these babies and children and adults, actually, as they grow up. And this is one way I think that we can do that is to support our youth ministry in any way possible. And we have 3 youth endowments in the Pulaski Heights United Methodist Church. It's unusual for a local church to have 3 youth endowments. The first one was started several years ago, and it's not just, but it's called Youth Endowment. And this was started by a donation to Reverend Nixon from a member who wanted to do something special for youth. And then when our beloved Win Rockefeller died, Mrs. Rockefeller designated his memorials here at the church to go to that youth endowment. So it grew quite a bit at that time. Then our second youth endowment is the Garth and Joanne Martin Endowment. And that was started by Garth and Joanne's 3 sons in honor of a very significant birthday for Garth. And And so that is the Garth and Joanne Martin. And both of those two benefit youth ministry in general, all kinds of enriching youth ministry in any way possible. And then our third youth endowment is the Betty Meyer Local Mission Endowment. And that was begun by a gift from Dr. Richard Meyer and his family in memory of Betty when she died. And that's designated for local mission efforts in the state. So when our youth go out to OMP or do local mission week or some of those other activities, then that youth endowment may be helping them. Now I would like for, I know the Martin family is represented and I know the Meyer family is represented. Would you all stand and let people express their appreciation to you? Britt has already said this, but I think I'd be remiss if I didn't, as your foundation director, add my endorsement of that. Please be generous tonight. I think we probably made a tactical mistake in a way. We probably should let them sing first and then take up the money because everyone would be so appreciative and excited about hearing it. But I'm sure you've got more than one check in your checkbook anyway, and so if you are moved, you can always contribute at the end of the service. There'll be youth out there with baskets, I'm sure. I believe that's all that I have, except once again expressing appreciation to Jay and Karen Clark and to our pianist, our accompanist Greg Taylor. So we want to express appreciation to them. Have I forgotten anything? Anybody? Just tell me. I'm not, I'll never mind. Okay, well, let's enjoy the show.
PH Youth is excited to be partnering with the PHUMC Foundation for this fundraiser for the Youth Endowments tonight.
We will have a love offering at the end of our time together and invite you to give generously, as your donations will help all aspects of youth ministry at PHUMC.
And now, welcome the cast of Celebrate Youth, who will sing a song from the musical Snoopy, based on the characters of Charles Schulz's Peanuts cartoon.
I know now that you can't bend a cracker. No matter how hard you try,
you may try.
I know now that your body isn't leaking when you cry.
When you cry.
I know now that a smile makes a lousy umbrella. I know now we should not try to sing a cappella.
Hit it!
Daisy, they flap every chance they get.
I know now it's impossible to rain a violet.
I know now the price of a thought is a penny.
I know now why the kids didn't sell very many.
If any.
Gee, how great it would be if I could go back somehow and have my life to live over, knowing what I know now. would be if I could go back somehow and have my life to live over.
Chrysanthemum! I know now that you can't buy a bike for a dollar. I know now that you can't fit a flea with a collar. Get it, Sarah?
I know now that you can't milk a cowslip.
You can, but it takes no how.
Just think of it, gee, how great it would be if I could go back somehow and have my life to live over, knowing what I know, knowing what I know now.
We have an awesome group of adult volunteers that help out each week. Adults that love us unconditionally, coaching basketball, teaching Sunday school, leading small groups, or going on mission experiences. One of the things each of those adults have in common is there's a piece of their childhood that draws them to working with young people, their inner kid coming to life again.
There's a kid inside, and I'll have him with me always. There's a kid inside, walking down old high school hallways. There's a kid inside, at a desk, at a dance, in the halls, in the showers. There's a kid inside, to this very day. And he makes a try for that high pop fly that I fumbled one September. And he makes a fuss over some A-plus that I shouldn't still remember. And he goes along, getting hurt, getting mad, fighting fights that are over. And unless I'm strong, all my senses are carried away. I can feel my hand, my trembling hand, on Michelle's Angora sweater. I can hear my band, that awful band, only now it sounds much better. I can see the kid I used to be, on the stage, on the field, on the lunch line. I can hear him tugging at me. Every time I think I don't care, I blink and he's there again. He's there again. Fighting ancient wrongs, humming old hit songs in my head. Singing, come along, come along. Time and place I could not forget if I tried. There again, he's there again. And I never know when that breeze will blow with the rush of old sensations. Why my kid should ache and my heart should break with the smell of old carnations. Something rings a bell, anything at all. All it takes is a slam of a locker or the switch from summer to fall. A change of season seems barely reason, but there he goes again, humming his songs. He's there again, there again. There's a kid inside.
Thank you.
We learn to depend on each other a lot within the youth ministry. We learn throughout our time together that we can depend on each other and genuinely care about each other. We now are friends because of our faith, brothers and sisters through and in Christ. Friendships like that are important. Here are two real sisters to sing about it.
Many of you remember the musical Godspell. The song Beautiful City was in the movie version, but not the stage version. Godspell tells the story we read in the Gospel of Mark. Here is Ollie Burrow singing Beautiful City. We
Ruth Sherwood is the main character in the musical Wonderful Town. She's a no-nonsense kind of gal who tells it like it is. She tells you about her experience with dating in the song 100 Easy Ways, sung by Jenny Williams, followed by the classic Gershwin song, But Not For Me, sung by Jordan Taylor.
Chapter 1. And fix it in 2 seconds flat with a bobby pin. That's a good way to lose a man. He takes you to a baseball game. You sit knee to knee. He says the next guy up at bat will bunt. You'll see. Don't say, oh, what's a bunt? This game's too hard for me. Just say, bunt, what are you, nuts? With no outs, two men on base, and a left-handed batter coming up, he'll walk right into the triple play just like it happened in the fifth game of the World Series in 1923. That's a fine way to lose a man. A fine, 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 fine way to lose a man. A splendid way to lose a man. Just throw your knowledge in his face. He'll never try for second base. 98 ways to go. Oh, the third way. Man. The lifeguard on the beach that all the girlies adore swims bravely out to save you through the ocean's roar. Don't say, oh, thank you, I'd have drowned in just 1 second more. Just throw his head underwater and yell, last one in's the rotten egg, and then race him back to shore. That's a sure way to lose a man. Your perfect mate, and it's been love from the start. He whispers, you're the one to who I give my heart. Don't say, I love you too, dear. Let's never, ever part. Just say, I'm afraid you've made a grammatical error. It's not to who I give my heart, it's to whom I give my heart. You see, with the preposition to, who becomes the indirect object, making use of the word whom, imperative, which I can very easily show you by drawing you a simple chart. That's a sure way to lose a man. A sure, 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 sure way to lose a man. A dandy way to lose a man. Just be more well-informed than he. You'll never hear, oh, promise me. Just show him where his grammar errs. Then mark your towels, hers, and hers. Yes, girls, you too can lose your man. If you'll just use old Jenny's plan. 100 easy ways to lose a man. And that's all I got.
The experts say it does not last. The experts say it's fleeting. The experts bray, love fades so fast. Then tell me, why is my heart still beating? Shouldn't I be less in love with you? Shouldn't I address what time can do? Shouldn't I be more inclined to flee? Shouldn't I explore all I can be? Shouldn't I address a sordid fling? Shouldn't I caress a cute younger thing? Shouldn't I assess what we've been through? Shouldn't I be less in love with you? After 30 years together, all those brutal fights, those futile fights, and the sleepless nights. Shouldn't I have quit because marriage ends? Shouldn't we have split like all our friends? Shouldn't I profess it's time to go? Shouldn't I be less in love with you?
As we move into the second half of the concert, we want to share some things about the PHUMC ministry that you might not know.
Did you know we spend 6 weeks a year doing mission work? We usually go out of state for spring break, alternating between hands-on mission and educational mission.
We also do 3 weeks of Ozark Mission Project around the state, plus a local mission week just serving in Little Rock. We are also volunteers for Vacation Bible School, and we have a prison ministry, nursing home ministry, serve as buddies at Miracle League, and lead worship at Methodist Family Health.
Lastly, we send a group of 6 to 8 youth with a medical mission team to Guatemala to assist as willing helpers. To attend the Guatemala mission, you must have completed other mission opportunities and be a sophomore or above.
Mission is an important part of our identity. We always appreciate your prayers and gifts towards these experiences that help mold us into service-oriented young adults. Now on with the show.
Tell me your problem. Strange but nice. Your heart goes pitter-patter. I know just what's the matter. You see, I've been there once or twice. Put your head on my shoulder. You need someone who's older. I rub down with a velvet glove. There is nothing you can take to remove this pleasant ache. You're not sick, you're just in love. You don't need analyzing. Not so surprising that you feel very strange but nice. Your heart goes pitter-patter. I know just what's the matter. You see, I've been there once or twice. Hey! Put your head on my shoulder. You need someone who's older. Rub down with a velvet glove. You're not sick, you're just in love. There is nothing you can take to remove this pleasant ache. You're not sick, you're just in
something completely different from the musical Jane Eyre. Thank you. make you feel small. When it's hardest to bear, then you'll do nothing at all. Forgiveness is the simplest vow. Forgiveness of all our crimes is your deliverance now. Bless those souls who would curse your name when the last bell tolls. You'll be free from blame. You can continue to grieve, but know the gospel is true. You must forgive those who time will come when we all must leave this world. And then the injustice and the pain and the sin will fall away. And only the spark of a spirit will remain, returning to God who created it. You must never lose faith. You must never lose heart. God will restore your trust. And I know you're afraid. I'm as scared as you are, but willing to be brave, brave enough for
Confirmation ministry is one of the cornerstones of our church. It is a milestone for many families, many who are just entering the life of the church. It is not uncommon to have several sixth graders enter confirmation and join the church before their parents. We are currently enrolling for our new confirmation year, so if you know of anyone interested, send them on and know that they will be well taken care of.
Pardon me, miss, but I've never done this with a real live girl. Straight off the farm with an actual arm full of real live girl. Pardon me if your affectionate squeeze fogs up my goggles and buckles my knees. I'm simply drowned in the sight and the sound and the scent. Similes that have set my heart up in a whirl, but nothing can beat getting swept up your feet by a real live girl. Dreams in your bunk don't compare to the hunk of a real live girl. Speaking of miracles, this must be it. Just when I started to learn how to knit,
that research shows that if a young person has five adults in their local church that know them and care about them, that young person will be more likely to continue their faith journey when they graduate high school. It's true, and not just Jay or Jenny, but you. When we are active in the life of the church, we see you, we get to know you, and we build a relationship with you that lasts. For that, we say thank you for giving us a chance and getting to know us.
We're riding on a kite. Let's see.
these next three songs were chosen because they're all originally sung by guys. We were trying to think of a theme for songs, and that's what we came up with. So there you go.
Pine away, but you pine away. just kissed a girl named Maria, and suddenly I found how wonderful the sound can be. Maria, say it loud and there's music playing. Say it soft and it's almost like praying. Maria, I'll never stop saying Maria.
Thank you for letting us be a part of your lives and a part of the life of this church.
We will be at the doors after to collect any donations. Thanks again to the PHUMC Foundation. Also, I want to recognize our accompanist for tonight, Gregory Taylor. Thank you all very much.
I don't know what's going on. Can
Changed. the path they take.
Wishes come true.
I asked him if we could have an encore, and he said no. We thank you so much. This is such a gift for our congregation. You all were all, each and every one, so special. You gave us a treasure tonight, and we thank you so very much. Where are our narrators?
They're at the doors.
Oh, they're at the doors, I know, to enter. But these people are going to stay here for a minute. So can they come in for just a second?
Sure, you all come back in for a minute.
Come back in, because you all were a big part of this also, and we want to express our appreciation to you. We have roses for everyone. We have special little bouquet for Karen and one for Grace since she's leaving us this year. And we thank you very much. And let's now all go to love God and love neighbor and change the world as these young people are doing for us. Thank you for coming tonight.